Good evening, everyone. I'm Paul Herriott, and welcome to another RTE Lyric Live with the National Symphony Orchestra. It has been said that the voice is our first instrument, and if that really is the truth, then it's no surprise, perhaps, that many conductors or violinists, for example, might find inspiration in a vocal turn of phrase. And by the same token, many vocalists gain a certain virtuosic instrumental quality within their own performances. But to find one musician who is capable of blending all three, well, that would be impossible. That is, unless, of course, you are Dmitry Sinkovsky, our extraordinary Baroque virtuoso this evening, who will blend all three of his talents as not only conductor, but also as countertenor and violinist, and together with the lutenist Luca Pianca, they will bring to life, and I really do mean to life, works by Vivaldi, Handel, and a little later on, Mozart. But to begin our program this evening, we turn to one of the great musical innovators of the Baroque era, the French composer Jean-Féry Rebel, and three excerpts, La Chaccona, and finishing with La Caprice from his ballet Les Élémens. Before we hear the music, please welcome the National Symphony Orchestra and our leader today, Claire Duff. Now, normally at this stage, I would, of course, welcome our conductor, and that is partly what I'm going to do right now, but it is only a third of the story, because he is indeed, as I've said, our conductor, our countertenor, and our violinist. Please welcome Dmitry Sinkovsky. Jean-Féry Rebel, the French composer, one of the Baroque era's great musical innovators, as those three excerpts from his ballet Les Elements thrillingly have demonstrated. Le Cahors, Chaccona and Caprice from that ballet by the Parisian composer who made such a mark on the operatic and orchestral platforms at the time, and particularly he played an important transitional point in the development of Baroque music, and a beautiful beginning to our programme this evening with the multitasking conductor, countertenor and violinist Dmitry Sinkovsky directing from the violin there the National Symphony Orchestra. As we turn now to the first of two works that we're going to hear this evening by Vivaldi. We're going to hear Vivaldi's Concerto per la Solennità di San Lorenzo in D major. Well, this is a work that was written specifically for the Feast of St. Lawrence. And Vivaldi wrote several concertos, some of them, of course, for many instruments, forming that particular type of concerto grosso. And then, in 1716, he turned to this work, scored for violin, two oboes, two horns, cello and strings. Returning to the stage, Dmitry Sinkovsky directing once again from the violin the National Symphony Orchestra with Vivaldi's Concerto per Solennità di San Lorenzo in D.
Thank you. Thank you.
The Andante, Rave and Allegro, the three movements from Vivaldi's Concerto per la Solennità di San Lorenzo in D. One of the, approximate 500 of those works. And a wonderful response here in the National Concert Hall to Dmitry Sinkovsky, directing from the violin the National Symphony Orchestra. Leader this week, Claire Duff. Extraordinary performance, an extraordinary life within it, for which Sinkovsky is so well regarded. And it's gone down a treat with our audience, as I say, here at the National Concert Hall, in this unique programme of essentially Baroque music. So much more to come. It works by Handel when Sinkovsky will prove his great adept as a countertenor. But we turn now to this next concerto, also by Vivaldi for lute. The Lute Concerto from 1730, when Vivaldi was writing several pieces for the instrument, and Luca Pianca, the Swiss lutenist, now joining the orchestra for this work. This work following the conventional pattern of a fast opening movement, followed by a slow one and a fast dance-like finale. The Lute Concerto, RV93 by Vivaldi. Thank you.
Allegro guisto largo and allegro, the three movements from Antonio Vivaldi's delightful Lute Concerto, RV 93, one of Vivaldi's most popular works, one of his most enduring, written for this particular instrument. And if it sounds familiar to many of us, it may be because it is a much-loved staple on many guitarists' repertoires. But tonight, we heard it played by a lutenist of great consequence. Luca Pianca, born in Lugano in Switzerland, studied under the guidance of the legendary Niklas Arnoncourt at the Mozarteum in Salzburg before beginning a long-term collaboration with Consentius Musicus Wien. And in 1987, he co-founded in Milan that year the Ensemble Il Giardino Armonico, one of the leading Italian period instrument ensemble. What a delight it is to hear that work performed for us this evening as it was originally intended. A few brief arrangements on the stage before the return of Dmitry Sinkovsky, completing the third part of his promise this evening as countertenor with Quel nave smarrita from Handel's Radamisto, like a ship that is stranded between shallows and tempests. This a tale of lust, tyranny, and noble love. Like a ship that is stranded between the shallows and tempests, there's neither light nor harbour to quell the fear. While Nave, Smarrita from Radamisto, by Handel, his tale of lust, tyranny and noble love, written for London audiences back in 1719, Dmitry Sinkovsky, the countertenor with the National Symphony. Furibondo spira il vento from Handel's Partenope, who furiously blows the winds and stirs the heavens and earth. That is what I feel now in my soul, agitated by my grief. And the extraordinary voice there of Dmitry Sinkovsky, also directing, of course, this evening the National Symphony Orchestra in this splendid program of Baroque treasure. That opera set in Naples in classical times, and that aria taken from Act Two, sung by Arsaci, Prince of Corinth, to Partenope, the Queen of Naples. Dmitry Sinkovsky who has conducted this evening, who has played upon his violin earlier on in one of Vivaldi's concertos, and who has offered us that glorious aria. One of two arias this evening from Handel, performed by our extraordinary, tri-talented performer this evening. Well, we've got lots more to come in the second half of our concert. Dmitry Sinkovsky takes up the podium once again as merely conductor, but for the Symphony No. 38 in D major by Mozart, Mozart's Prague Symphony. That's what's coming up in the second half of our concert this evening. But in our interval now, Vlad Smyskevich explores in a very timely way, surely, the wonders of the human voice. And our thanks to Vlad Smitskevich for his interval on the human voice. Paul Herriott with you here at the National Concert Hall in Dublin. You're listening to RTE Lyric Live. And it would be hard to overestimate the power and the draw of Mozart's appeal across Europe, particularly in Prague during the late 1780s. His latest opera, The Marriage of Figaro, had taken the city by storm, and in 1786 it would soon be followed by the premiere of Don Giovanni at the Estates Theatre the following year. But compounding that initial success, Mozart, along with his wife Constanza, would visit the Czech capital for something more akin to a short residency of concerts. Well, along with the treasures on offer, Mozart had brought with him his latest symphony, the one that we know today as number 38 in D major, regarded, it seems, by the all-important Viennese audience at the time as something of a tensely brooding statement. The Prague audience, on the other hand, could not get enough. Applause for the National Symphony Orchestra, declared off under the direction of musical chameleon Dmitry Sinkovsky.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Presto and that third and final movement from Mozart's Symphony No. 38 in D major. Regarded, it seems, by the all-important Viennese audience in 1876 as something of a rather tensely brooding statement. The Prague audience, on the other hand, embraced wholeheartedly its diverse range of emotions and rewarded it, as our audience does this evening, with boundless generosity. And it's little surprise that today we know this work as Mozart's Prague Symphony. Well, applause for the National Symphony Orchestra and leader Claire Duff, under the direction of undoubtedly our musical chameleon, no question about that, this evening, Dmitry Sinkovsky, who has delighted the audience here in the National Concert Hall with his extraordinary range of performance as conductor, as countertenor, and violinist. We've heard him in all three of those roles this evening, bringing to life, and I really do mean to life in every sense of the term, every work that we have heard. And receiving there from the orchestra, a sunflower. A sunflower, as does indeed the leader of the orchestra this evening, Claire Duff. And the audience really enjoyed, I think, the variant of that programme this evening, all the way from the heart of the Baroque to the heart of the classical era. Sound supervision this evening, Kieran Cullen and Damien Gavigan. Technical backup, Owen O'Dwyer. Production coordinator was Peter Curtin and producer, Gail Henry. I'm Paul Herriott, and from all of us here at the National Concert Hall, I very much hope that you enjoyed our live concert this evening.
Friends, we prepare a little surprise for you. And together,